It's a great pleasure for me to open this conference. This is number 7, and we organize this every 2 years. The main topic of this conference would be to go into good governance, into institutional quality, as you see in the title here, which is sometimes very difficult to measure, of course. Sustainable convergence is now one of the focuses of our convergence report.
Our region used to grow fast, and now it's not growing fast. Reforming the institutions is exactly the challenge. We see that EU membership matters. EU membership in our region is the single most important factor. Transition was about replacing unfair equality with fair inequality. Unfortunately, in many of our countries, we have unfair inequality, inequality of opportunity. Our countries are slowing down. This is a fact. And this slowdown is actually worse than in comparable middle-income economies. And this is something that is driven by the need to reinvent the growth model. The old growth model has exhausted itself. So we need to think about growth model based on human capital, innovation, firm dynamics. And for that, of course, we need better institutions that protect competition, provide incentives to integrate with the global economy, innovate, and so on.
A major shift is needed to help the region achieve a new growth model based on innovation and skills. CC countries have only one way to restart the convergence machine, and that is to accelerate and intensify their reform efforts. We need to work on both boosting growth and making it inclusive. Formally, what is needed is, of course, checks and balances, oversight frameworks, and institutional settings, and they are mostly in place. But really, what is needed and what is lacking is the genuine belief in their functioning.
What are the preconditions for negotiations? First chapter analyzed the political criteria under the title of Democracy and Rule of Law. It's no surprise that these issues remain a cornerstone in the European Union. Investments are the most important, but without institutions you don't have them. So they go hand in hand.
PFP is the key for the future convergence process.
What we still do not understand too well, I think, is the interaction between the political system and the economic prosperity. I would like to strike a bit more positive tone. And I think we have to keep in mind where we come from. Overall, a big economic experiment has worked. Nominal convergence is a precondition, but real convergence is required to make a common currency a sustainable advantage.
Yes, we all observed the economic convergence, but there is still some lack in institutional and particularly cultural view on convergence. EU membership does matter and does promote the convergence in this respect. Once you enter the EU, the institutional convergence slows down. Once you are in, you put the handbrake and then just enjoy the wave of being in the group of others. And then maybe this is also the question whether the institutions that we are jointly building in the European Union are still continuing to improve the institutional quality.